Welcome to this video on integration of omics data. I'm Cristina Furlan, and I'm a lecturer at the System and Synthetic Biology Department at Wageningen University and Research. Let's consider you're involved in a project in which you're studying bacteria that are growing in a biofilm, as we did in the FAIR data management video, if you have seen it. You like to dissect the development of this community via multiple omics approaches. You collect genomics information, then transcriptomics at different time points, then you further analyze some key time point samples via proteomics, and finally, you record also the metabolomics information for all samples in each time point. You additionally do this analysis both for a wild type and a mutant strain, as exemplified by the blue and green labels. What can you do with the data? Well, you can just look at the individual levels, or you can try to connect information from the different levels together, doing what is called data integration. In this video, we will describe what it is the goal of data integration, focusing on explaining two types of integration, horizontal and vertical integration. When do you want to integrate data? Basically, when we want to find further associations among them. One case could be in our biofilm example, when you collected data on the transcriptional activity of your biofilm at different times, and another lab has collected data on the same sample type that could be added to your analysis, or you added some extra transcriptomics experiment on the same type of sample, but different conditions. In this case, you have the same type of variables, namely the active genes, that are measured, yet coming from different studies. For such a case, there is a general workflow to find associations and visualize them in a network. We start by making the data uniform, for example, by processing them in the same way so that you can put all variables and conditions together. We then look for associations among the active genes in this big matrix and build this association via network representation. A network is a graph of concepts and relations. Nodes, the dot in the figure, represent variables, and edges, the connection between the dots, the significant association. So you can already appreciate by zooming in the previous network that this group, number 25 and colored in red, are genes that are sharing some association or characteristics. Now, let's move on to vertical integration, when we want to join data from different data types collected on the same samples. Why should you integrate data in case of different data type? We can actually study these different levels that bring us from genotype to phenotype using conventional molecular biology tools, following in such a way a hypothesis-driven approach. In this example, you would study a gene, identify maybe a few targets for transcriptional changes connected to the expression of this gene, then move to the protein level and focus on studying its interaction or activity in the case of an enzyme. And finally, look at the molecule transformed or produced by the enzyme and influencing metabolism. With the development of the omics technology, we can definitely expand our knowledge on each level. And so we can generate discoveries driven by data. In such a case, you would test a general condition or change from the wild type condition and start from the changes observed to deduce an hypothesis explaining those differences and move to test that hypothesis in follow-up experiments. Yet nowadays, we can integrate the different omics level to reach a more holistic understanding of the system. This allows us to get an insight into the relationship between the omics level and molecular mechanisms describing the condition studies. Finally, we can also develop predictive analytical models that report a signature for the condition that can be used for future estimation on a known sample of the same type. So, as you can appreciate, the final picture of the data available nowadays is more complex. We can have different intervention on different phenotypes, collecting different type of variables, measurements, and all of this in different time. Our aim is then to link the genotype and the environment to the observed phenotype in terms of production traits or implication for health. And we do this through the measurement of the different internal variables, so the different omics. Now, how can we integrate data? So we can do that by individual levels, combining individual levels, and look afterwards at correlations and overlaps among the different variables. We can also use network approaches, where nodes, in this case, represent different types of variables, so proteins, metabolites, genes. You can use Bayesian statistic approaches to measure the amount of information a data set provides to parameter estimate, and this probability distribution can then be updated based on each of the different data sets. Finally, you can use matrix factorization for the integration. In this case, a large matrix of data is decomposed into smaller matrices that represent the underlying factors or latent components of the data. These latent components capture the shared variation across multiple data sets and can be used to identify a relationship between the data sets. To sum up, in this video, we showed when and why it is important to integrate omic data to reach a holistic description of the system we are studying. We introduced few methods that can be used to achieve data integration. We then focus on defining two types of possible integration of omics data: horizontal, for same variable but different studies, and vertical, for same samples but different data type. If you wish to learn more about the use of network for data integration, you can refer to our extended seminar in the link in the resources. Now, can you think of some of your data that you now want to go and examine further by integrating them?